It was a budget reply high on promises and catchy phrases.
Cheaper childcare.
A more generous subsidy rate affecting 96% of families with more than one child under six.
Protecting Medicare.
A yet-to-be-announced package to make it easier for Aussies to see the doctor. And the piece de resistance, a five-point plan to improve aged care.
To put the care back into aged care.
Including a round-the-clock registered nurse in every facility.
We are going to put the nurses back into nursing homes.
Better food.
Mandatory nutrition standards.
More carers.
Every Australian living in aged care receives a minimum of 215 minutes of care per day.
And crucially, better pay.
A real pay rise for aged care workers.
We are given a hope that we can afford rent, afford probably a house later on.
But no detail on what the pay rise would be and how we'd actually pay for it.
25% taking aged care workers up to disability workers, so that is broadly something Labor would support.
Michael, again, I just say it's not my place to get involved in Fair Work's deliberations.
Today, the Coalition took aim at Labor's playbook.
He thinks an economic plan is handing in his Year 10 economics assignment to the Parliament. We want to see more detail.
He knows the cost of nothing. And if you know the cost of nothing, well, you can't trust him with the finances.
Labor's tax policy, or lack of it so far, also coming under fire.
Will you increase taxes?
Will you increase taxes?
The tax that we're looking at is multinational tax evasion.
You won't be increasing taxes.
What we'll do is two things.
But you won't increase taxes.
We have all of our policies out there.
I don't know that you're answering the question.
Three times he was asked, will you increase taxes? Fudged it, couldn't answer.
But an unfazed Albo is sticking with his new slogans.
Childcare,
Medicare,
aged care, because Labor cares.
And Shadow Aged Care Minister Claire O'Neill joins us now. Claire, obviously everyone wants old people to be cared for. That is a given. But the truth is, we're currently looking at an uncosted promise that you're making. Are we any closer to knowing the true price of this?
Well, a couple of points on what you said just there. I truly believe that the biggest social crisis facing our country right now is the absolute mistreatment of older Australians in aged care. My frustration is that the government doesn't see it that way. And what we saw this week was on Thursday night, Anthony Albanese stand up in his budget reply and say, actually, if Labor's elected, we are going to take this on and we are going to fix this aged care system so that older Australians and their families feel confident about leaving a loved one in an aged care home, which is something that most people never want to do. Now, you asked about the cost of the policy. We have costed very carefully the portions of this policy that can be costed. We are going to provide 24/7 nursing, so there's nurses in every nursing home in the country. We're going to increase the minutes of care so that carers have got more time with the people that they're caring for. We're going to make sure that there's proper transparency and accountability in this system. And the most important thing that we will do is make sure that aged care workers get a pay rise. Now, this is something that cannot be costed currently because the Fair Work Commission is making a decision about what the appropriate pay level is going to be. But can I just tell you, this is essential to fixing this system. We cannot improve aged care unless we fix the problem with aged care workers.
But Claire, at every election that I think that any of us can remember, the Coalition's line against Labor is that the Coalition is better economic managers. You've just announced this centrepiece policy, which you can't detail how much it will cost. You're not going to be able to say the answer to that before the election. Was that a mistake?
Well, Hamish, actually, I don't think you've characterised that correctly there. So there is a portion of the policy that can be costed. That's $2.5 billion over the coming 4 years. What can't be costed here is a decision that is pending in the Fair Work Commission, which will change the rate of pay for aged care workers. But what people need to understand is whether a Labor government's elected after the election or a Liberal government is elected, it is a core responsibility of that next national government to fund this increase to workers' pay. The difference between Labor and Liberal is that we're saying we're going to step up, we're going to stop doing what this government's been doing for 9 years, and that is subjecting older Australians to disgraceful neglect.
Sure.
We have a system that supports older Australians.
With respect, I don't think anyone's challenging you on the standards that currently exist. It's just that $2.8 billion is not really the true cost of fixing the problems in aged care. We're talking about many multiples of that, aren't we? And if that's the case, Australian voters are going to want to know where that money comes from elsewhere.
Yeah, and again, Hamish, this is not something that can be costed, and the government is in exactly the same position as the opposition in relation to this. Whoever is in government at the time is going to have to fund somehow an increase for aged care workers. The difference we have here is that Labor wants to actually fix this. We want to make a system that looks after older Australians properly, that doesn't see people sitting in soiled pads for hours on end, doesn't see people lying on the floor because no one's there to help them get up again. We want a dignified aged care system, and the parts of this policy that will allow us to do that can be costed have been costed. This is a crucial social reform, Hamish, and I just point you to something that happened this week in Canberra. Josh Frydenberg gave his budget on Tuesday night. He spent $40 billion without telling us really where that money's going to come from. Now, this is not going to cost as much as that. It is a much more important investment that we're going to make that will rebuild aged care in this country.
Well, Claire, we're going to have to leave it there, but thank you very much for your time.
Lovely to talk to you guys. Thanks so much.
You know, the thing about this conversation about how much this is going to cost, for me, I agree with you. We all want aged care to be better. We all want the people in our lives to be cared for in a much more, you know, respectful and humane way. But for me, I kind of go, well, it just comes down to priorities. You know, where does the government want to spend their money? And if they have the willpower, they will find the money. They will find the money to do what's right, surely.
It's been so long. There's been a Royal Commission into it. You know, it just feels like the time where action just needs to be taken, doesn't it?
Yeah, absolutely. And I think that we've heard that the current government has invested billions over the last 9 years. Well, where's the evidence of that then? Mm. How are we in such crisis if that's been the case?
You know where they could get the money from? Inheritance. which...